this is the most frequently asked question about my skin. How did I go from that to this? So I've been using this product for as long as I can remember, and then I ran out and I forgot to repurchase it. But recently I saw someone on TikTok talking about how it completely cleared their skin. So I knew I had to get my hands on it again. It helps to decongest pores, which is one of my main concerns, and it helps to promote smoother looking skin. And genuinely, this product has helped so much with my skin texture. It contains niacinamide too, which is perfect for brightening and hydrating, and it layers really, really well under my makeup. It is an absolute must have. This is the La Roche-Posay Everclear Duo Plus.
There's a reason this is going viral on TikTok. I've seen so many dermatologists talk about this. It is the La Roche-Posay Cicaplast B5 Balm. The one thing I'll say about it is I just wish I tried it sooner. If you're someone who likes to use actives, it is something I would recommend having in your cabinet. Look how glowy.
Love's real when you've already got another tube on standby.
What do you like about corn?
It's cold! A big corn that knocks, it has the juice! I can imagine a more beautiful thing!
I have no makeup. No bronzer, nothing. Like, literally, just woke up and washed my face with CeraVe cleanser. This is the product you need in your life. The Cicaplast, probably saying that wrong, B5. Game changer.
Know who the first person was to put snail slime on their face and think it was a good idea. Lucky for them, it actually was a good idea. Snail slime is also called snail mucin in the skincare world, and it's exactly what it sounds like. CosRx has a snail mucin power essence, 96% snail secretion filtrate. Go to part 2 to see if this ingredient would be good for you.
We gonna fuck up the night. Black lights. This shit's fine.
Are you supposed to use this product? Here's a collection of what I've learned after we're into our third week of testing this product now. As we all know, it's marketed as a balm and a dry skin treatment, but so many people use it to treat acne. So how can we use this? What's the best way? If you look at the comments on any video on this product, it's pretty divisive, and the line is usually whether or not it's caused a breakout. So here's my theory. Silicone is the third ingredient in this product, which, you know, is long lasting. It's very stubborn to wash off. The second ingredient is a gel-like thick emollient, which is very hydrating. It's the same ingredient in the Hailey Bieber Rode Peptide Lip Treatment. It's the same in this lip treatment. So it's very hydrating, and it's been proven to deliver long-lasting hydration benefits to for dry skin. It's a common win. Unless there's a particular ingredient that your skin is irritated to, it typically works well with dry skin, which is expected because it's typically not as prone to pores blocking and flaring up because your sebum is not as overactive. For acne-prone skin, this might be too heavy. Now, heavy, not in a good, I need this because I'm using so many actives like benzoyl peroxide, salicylic acid, tretinoin, Roaccutane kind of way, but heavy in a stubborn kind of way, in that it's hard to wash off. So what do I think? I think if you have dry skin and you love it, that's great, keep using it. Silicone is in many different products, and if it doesn't bother you, that's amazing and you're really lucky. Now what if you're suspicious of silicone, but you still want to use this product? Depending on how you feel and your skin type, try keep it to once a day, even just a few times a week, because that's much easier to wash off any residue that it might leave. This way you still get the nice barrier repair benefits without the overloading and blocking of the pores. Now if you're breaking out and you're looking for an alternative, come along with me and we can look into some other options for you. Spot treatment or all over. So what I've just mentioned is how I would use it if it was all over the face. Use it as the last step in your routine and only follow with SPF if you're using in the day. Now spot treatment. What is a spot? This can work on cracked corners of the mouth, patches of irritation, redness, dryness, itchiness, insect bites. So you might want to locally apply it to a problemed area. If I were to keep using this is how I would continue to use this product, because it does have ingredients that help with those inflamed conditions of acne and have soothing properties to the skin. So that's what I think and what I've learned from my trial. What do you think? Do you like this? Is it worth the hype? Will you keep using it? Let us know.
Watch him make it, break it down, the music will just ooze. Round man, who the hell are you?
I've heard so many dermatologists talk about this. It is the La Roche-Posay, it's the Everclear Duo Plus. It's a moisturiser, but it's also like a blemish treatment in one. It gives me the confidence to know that by morning, the blemishes are going to appear more reduced. Oh, and my fellow sensitive skin peeps, This is so, so sensitive skin friendly, and you'll know how tricky it is to find a blemish treatment that's also sensitive skin friendly. So this one is a keeper.
My go-to blemish treatment right here.
Let's do skincare with me.
1. Do Ordinary
Hyaluronic Acid
2.
Serum.
Cozex
Snail Mucin Essence.
3.
La Roche Posay
Cicatrice Plast Balm.
Hello, lovely people. So today I'm going to show you 3 ways to use the La Roche Posay Cicatrice Balm B5. I love this product, so let's get into it. First way is what I call the spot treatment method. I like to put this over any crusty breakouts, any scars I have, any skin that just isn't looking good. I dot it all over. I sleep with it overnight. You will wake up and I swear the inflammation's gone by 50%. Method 2, the 10-minute mask. I like to do this before I do my makeup. I put it over any dry spots, any crusty spots. I let it sit for 10 minutes. I wipe it off with a damp cloth, and my skin is baby smooth, perfect for makeup. Last method is the overnight mask. I love doing this on recovery days when I'm skin cycling. I apply a fat layer all over my skin. I want to look pasty white. I leave this on overnight, wake up, my skin's like a baby's butt. So let me know how you use the Cicatrice.
Acne-prone skin? Same. Here's how I use La Roche-Posay Cicatrice Repair Balm. I apply it thinly over my skin and wipe it off after 15 minutes. I love the way it makes my skin glow. Do you have...
La Roche-Posay Cicatrice Balm B5 Hydration Test.
This product has saved my skin barrier.
I had a really damaged skin barrier, especially here. This is my problem area, and I was always breaking out because of it. It happened, and I know it was a skin barrier damage because I overused steroid cream and it went through a withdrawal and it was bad. So when your skin barrier is broken, it means your skin isn't being protected and you're gonna break out. And I was constantly breaking out here. And finally, I've been using this literally a week and it's already clearing up. It's not clearing up acne. It's not gonna clear up a breakout. I just mean if you're getting a breakout because of your skin barrier, this is gonna save your skin barrier.
Woo!